I know there's already a ton of poker players here. I can smell them. Yo, today is Tuesday. Already got up, came over, edited the vlog from yesterday, uploaded it. Gotta go do a couple of things now, including laundry. That's right, the World Series of Poker 2016 started today. I plan on going later, if I ever get finished with all the other shit that I have to do. So I need new pants for work. I went to a store earlier that sells Dickies. There's a certain style of Dickies that I like to wear to work, and they didn't have my size. I also need a new pair of jeans. So I just went to a store to get jeans, and they don't have my size. Today has been a colossal pain in the ass on a couple of different levels. Hopefully, I don't murder anyone in the laundromat, because if I was ever going to kill somebody, that is, you know, a place where it could very well happen. One more store. Then I'm off to the laundromat. Thank goodness I have this shit, because today is just one of those days. I don't know what you're thinking, Trooper. It seemed like every day is one of those days. Yeah, that's why I drink the shit. Sure, today's been frustrating, but hey, on the bright side, found the work pants. Yo, this entire day has been a pain in my ass. Laundry is done though. Thank goodness for that. I am darting west on Flamingo, and yes, I said darting. The reason I said darting is because I'm doing fucking 60. I'm approaching the Rio. Look at that. I can almost feel the electricity of the World Series of Poker. No, I'm just kidding. It's really not that big of a deal. There's just a lot of poker players here, or people who play poker, let's put it. Rough ass fucking road. Las Vegas fucking roads are fucking terrible. Oh, you fucking assholes. Hung up all my laundry and shit, and then I took a little nappy nap, all right? And so now I'm headed out. It's almost 11 p.m. though, fuck. Going to the Rio, day one of the World Series of Poker. I definitely need a coffee. The Starbucks inside the Rio is closing in 9 minutes, which is not good for me. So we're gonna swing left and then cut right, hit the Starbucks at Flamingo in Paradise. Do not come to Vegas without a jacket, a hoodie, a sweatshirt, because it is absolutely freezing
in the down at the World Series. I'm already seeing tons of hoodies, headphones, backpacks. Not that there's anything wrong with that. Just saying. Seeing it. They've got all these video poker machines lined up here at the entrance to the shit. I mean, are they trying to target poker players? I mean, is that what they're doing? This shit is all set up to rope off a line for the Colossus. That shit is this weekend. I don't know if you remember last year, there was like 37 million people in line. Pretty calm right now, but in a couple days it won't be.
Monique, this is your last call for 55 PLO.
So the live action room, he seems to be off to a decent start. There are a lot of games going. All right, awesome. First day of the World Series, minus 600 at 1-3. This guy raised with pocket eights, and the flop, I had king, queen. I called, and the flop was king, king, six, with two spades. He checked the flop, I let out, and the third person in the hand folded. And he just called. The turn was an ace, and he led out for 35. So I just called. The river was an eight, and he bet 60. And I don't know what happened. I called on the turn so that he would bet the river, but something happened. I can't really explain it, but I decided to just call the river. The motherfucker hit an eight on the river. Yeah, pocket eights. It was king, king, six, ace on the turn, and then the eight came on the river. So that was a nice two-outer for him, and a really good idea for whatever reason I decided not to raise. I mean, what was the guy leading on the turn for? Was he trying to represent the ace? I mean, what does his bet accomplish on the turn? It makes no sense, but anyway, that's besides the point. I mean, the only thing I can do is value raise the turn, and he's folding. Makes no sense for me to raise the turn, because he's fucking folding. So, two outer there. The very next hand, he raises to 15 under the gun, and I had ace king and $138. I raised to 60. And this crazy, maniacal, overly aggressive Asian lady. So anyway, it's an asinine bet on her part. Obviously I call, and obviously the queen comes. So, and then I said congratulations, and then I left. Normally I don't say much, but who the fuck cares? Minus 600 for me tonight is not good. It just really sucks that the World Series of Poker is starting, and I'm effectively broke. Can I afford to go and play sessions of poker? Yes, but I don't have a bankroll where I can sit down and play the game the way that it needs to be played. And, you know, there were a couple of spots tonight where I acted differently than I would have acted if I had a proper role. And I mean, that's just never good. It's just not good. The other day at the Wynn, there was at least one spot, if not more than one, where I would have played a hand completely differently if I wasn't so stuck, if I had a role. And I mean, it's definitely not good. It's just that when I'm in a spot like that, you know, where I felt like the right play was to raise and I didn't do it. I folded. I don't know. I guess I'm just gonna fucking spend the entire World Series of Poker, you know, playing on a short roll and really accomplish nothing by the end of it. So I'm not gonna lie, I'm discouraged. I can't play my best game because I'm severely fucking underrolled, and it's all my fault. It's my fault from the beginning of the day that I fucking landed here in Vegas. It's my fault. I should have a roll and things should be going differently, but it's not. That's it. That's the bottom fucking line. I can't play my best game. I'm telling you now, I can't play my best game because I'm underrolled, and the pots matter and the money matters. I don't know. This is no way to play poker. I'm telling you that right now. I'm just gonna fucking go home, go to sleep. I actually am getting up tomorrow. I have something fun to do tomorrow at 10 a.m. If you like the videos, click the thumbs up button, subscribe, tell your friends, and leave a comment below. I'll see you next time.